क्वेश्चन नंबर एट, लेट्स कॉम्प्रिहेंड. लेट व्हाट इज गिवन, लेट ए एंड बी बी पॉजिटिव रियल नंबर्स सच दैट ए ग्रेटर देन वन एंड बी लेस देन ए. लेट पी बी ए पॉइंट इन द फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट दैट लाइज ऑन द हाइपरबोला दस. सो ए हाइपरबोला, इक्वेशन इज गिवन, ए इज ग्रेटर देन वन एंड बी इज लेस देन ए. Suppose the tangent to the hyperbola at P passes through the point 1, 0. So a point P is in the first quadrant on the hyperbola. And tangent to the hyperbola at P passes through the point 1, 0. The normal to the hyperbola at P cuts off equal intercept on the coordinate axis. So normal to the hyperbola P cuts off equal intercepts on the coordinate axis. Let delta denote the area of triangle formed by the tangent at P, normal at P, and the x-axis. Okay. Now if E denotes the eccentricity of the hyperbola, so E is the eccentricity of the hyperbola. And what is asked? Which of the following statement is or are true? So in option A and B, the value of E, where does it lie? And in option C and D, two statement about the area of the triangle. Okay, let's analyze. I recall a line is a tangent to a second degree curve if on solving equation of line with curve gives repeated root. From the definition of tangent, the root is point where line is tangent to the curve. My quadratic equation has repeated roots if d equal to 0 and the value of the repeated root is minus b upon 2a. All basic results, basic definition, basic concepts, and the eccentricity of this hyperbola x square upon a square minus y square upon b square equal to 1 if b is less than a is e equal to this. So now I recognize that will be the figures. Hyperbola, first quadrant, point P, tangent here, passes at this point, 1, 0. Normal cuts off equal intercept. Now if normal cuts the equal intercept on the x-axis, y-axis, means the slope of this line will be minus 1. So I recognize this. The slope of tangent will be plus 1, m1, m2 is equal to minus 1. So as tangent passes through this, we have the slope of the tangent and a point through which it is passing. So we use point slope formula to find the equation of a line. So equation of tangent is y is equal to x minus 1. All basic results. Let's execute again, calculate the rest of the things. So on solving equation of tangent with equation of hyperbola, y equal to x minus 1. We just put the value of y in the equation of hyperbola. So we get a quadratic in x, a repeated root. Thoda sa simplify kar lete ho. D equal to 0, b square minus 4ab, b square 4ab equal to 0, b square into 1 plus b square minus a square. Simplify to this, b is not 0, so a square minus b square equal to 1. So we got this simple result, relation between a and b. And repeated root, minus b upon 2a, minus b upon 2a, which is a square. So x coordinate of point P is a square. Now we can get the y coordinate. Y coordinate is b square. So point P is a square, b square. Coordinate of point P we have got in terms of a and b. Now equation of normal, slope of the normal is minus 1, so point Q, we just check in the picture, point Q we have taken at the intersection of normal and x-axis. So we find this point, x-axis Q per point A, so y coordinate is 0, we get x coordinate. So we have this result and we will look for this. So E is equal to this, Now, a square is 1 plus b square. Now, b square upon 1 plus b square is definitely from 0 to 1. Denominator is 1 more than numerator, and numerator and denominator both are positive terms. So, b square upon 1 plus b square is 0 to 1. I have to check the value of e. So, add 1, 1 to 2, square root of both. We take the square root. So, eccentricity is from 1 to root 2. Simple calculations. I got the answer. True statement is A, not B. Incorrect. Now, look at the area of the required triangle. The triangle PQR. Area of the triangle is half into base into height. Half into QR into PS. QR is x coordinate of Q minus y x coordinate of R. And PS is y coordinate of point P ordinate. We put the value, we use this result, we get B to power 4. So option D is correct, option C is incorrect. I got my answers. It is option A and D. Straight simple approach. Everything based on NCRT. Nothing extra from the prescribed syllabus. No trick, no complication, no mystery. This is my approach. Straight simple approach, SS approach. No trick, no complication, no mystery. My name is Shishir Saini. I'm graduate of IIT Roorkee, class of 96. IIT JEE coach since 99. Thank you.